R.I.P. Google Podcasts. It was nice knowing ya.
It was nice knowing you too. If you're looking for new podcasts, popular choices, Crime Junkie, True Crime Stories, This American Life. Let me know if you want more recommendations. Smile.
Cool. Hey friends, I'm Tayshia Custody, and now that Google Podcasts is gone, these are the best podcast apps to replace Google Podcasts. We're going to start with a great alternative, Good Pods. This is a cross-platform alternative, so it works both on Android and iOS. You can create an account or continue as a guest if you want to try it out before you commit, but GoodPods allows you to follow your friends to discover new podcasts. You can track your podcast listens, you can bookmark podcasts for later, and more. So your feed is split between an everyone thread where you can see what people are listening to. There's a following tab to sort by who you're following, and then there's a groups tab if you create groups of your friends. It's easy to discover new podcasts via their recommendations and rating system where they show you the top 100 podcasts on GoodPods. You'll have to create an account before you subscribe to a podcast, though you can listen to podcast episodes without creating an account. It's not the fastest app I've tried, but it does get the job done. GoodPods is completely free with no in-app ads. Next up is AntennaPod. This is an Android-only app that might be the closest alternative to Google Podcasts. If you've been following me for a while, you know I love a good deal, and AntennaPod is completely free. There is no paid plan. It's open source, and you can subscribe to any RSS feed. There's not even a sign-in required. You just open the app, and you're off to the races. AntennaPod is also built by volunteers without commercial interest. Amen. But it's also just a nice, clean, easy to use podcasting app. It's really easy to discover interesting shows or search for and subscribe to a pod you're interested in. The settings section also allows for easy appearance customization where you can adapt the app colors based on your wallpaper, kind of a little material you touch. You can also import your other subscriptions as well. So before we go on, I have to confess, I was a big Stitcher user. RIP to another one of the greats. So these next couple apps could be great replacements, albeit no user interface is going to be the same. With that said, let's move on to what I'm going to dub the best podcast app for Android or for cross-platform, so iOS as well, and that's Pocket Casts. Pocket Casts is an oldie but a goodie, and its longevity is really a sign of how great their app is. It's really easy to sign up via Google, and I find the app is really intuitive and really easy to use. It is a cinch to browse featured podcasts and trending podcasts. Plus, it's got a 0.1 increment for increasing or decreasing the audio speed, which is really nice so you're not ramping up or ramping down the speed by half or more each time. There are also a silence trim feature and a volume boost feature as well, which is really nice. Pocket Casts is totally free, but you can upgrade to Plus for around $40 per year. So if you pay, you get access to some cloud storage and exclusive app icons and themes. I'm actually surprised with how much I love Pocket Casts on both Android and iOS. And if I'm picking a best podcast app for Android, then I guess it's only fair that I pick a best podcast app for iOS. Or I guess, well, another alternative for iOS if you're not into Pocket Casts. Because Apple's podcast app is... So if you're on iOS, may I suggest Overcast? This one's got some unique features. With Overcast, you can share clips. So this is my favorite feature of this app. With clip sharing, you can tell your friend about a show you love by sending them an audio or video clip from an episode up to 1 minute long. How cool is that? You can create a smart kind of custom playlist so that new episodes of specific podcasts are included in that list. Other awesome features include smart speed that dynamically shortens silences in shows without distortion. Yes, please. There's also voice boost, which boosts and normalizes the volume so every show is loud and clear and at the same volume. Amen. As far as the user interface, you don't have to log in to get started. You can simply search the directory of shows or add shows via a URL. Everything is neatly organized by most starred and per category for easy browsing. Your settings will easily tell you your storage and data usage, and there are nitpicky details to play around with. You can even set unlistened episode limits. Now, the free version contains visual ads, but there are very other few limitations for this free version. It's great. And you can upgrade to premium for just $9.99 per year. Not month, $9.99 for the whole year. Now that's pretty good. So those are the best podcast apps to replace Google Podcasts. Let me know what your favorite podcast apps are and why. Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, you can tap right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for more content just like this. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.